Hello students, welcome back to another video on metal space. Today we will start the new topic, sequential criteria and BWP. So the first of all, the definition of sequential criteria. Sorry, sequential compactness. Sequential compactness. So first of all, the definition of sequential compactness. Let XD be a metric space. XD be a metric space. The space, the metric space XD is said to be sequential compact, sequentially compact. Is said to be sequentially compact. The space XD is said to be sequentially compact if every sequence in that X has convergent subsequence. If every sequence, suppose XN, every sequence in that X has convergent subsequence. Metric space XD is said to be sequentially compact if every sequence in that metric space, every sequence in that space has convergent subsequence, then the given space XD is said to be sequential compact. Now the next definition is Bolzano-Weierstrass property, BWP. Next definition is Bolzano-Weierstrass property, Weierstrass, Bolzano-Weierstrass property. Bolzano-Weierstrass property. In short, we say that BWP. So the definition of BWP is a metric space XD is said to have that property whenever every infinite subset of that metric space has some limit point. So the definition of BWP is a metric space XD is said to have BWP, that is metric space XD is said to have Bolzano-Weierstrass property if every infinite subset of that space X has a limit point, Metric space XD is said to have BWP. We say that metric space XD has BWP if every infinite subset in that X must have limit point. If every infinite subset of metric space XD has limit point, then we say that given metric space XD has BWP, that is Bolzano-Weierstrass property. So the first definition of sequential compactness, metric space XD is said to be sequential compact if every sequence in that metric space has convergent subsequence. And the next topic is Bolzano-Weierstrass property. So definition of Bolzano-Weierstrass property is metric space XD is said to have that BWP if every infinite subset in that metric space has a limit point. Now we will see some theorem on sequential compactness and BWP. So the theorem is, statement of the theorem is, a metric space is sequentially compact. Metric space is sequentially compact if and only if it has BWP. It has Bolzano-Weierstrass property. Metric space is sequentially compact if and only if it has BWP. If the metric space has BWP, then the given metric space is sequentially compact and every sequentially compact metric space has BWP. So first of all, we will suppose first part and prove second, and in conversely, we will suppose this metric space has BWP and that metric space is sequentially compact. So the proof of the given theorem is, let xd be a matrix space and suppose that matrix space has bwb, or first of all we will suppose that matrix space is sequentially compact and we will prove it has bwb. Let xd be a matrix space, xd be a matrix space. First of all we will assume that xd is sequentially compact. X is sequentially compact. Sequentially compact means every sequence in that x has convergent subsequence. So we have to prove that this matrix space xd has bwp. So for that we have to prove that every infinite subset of that x has limit points. So we will suppose one arbitrary infinite subset of x. So let capital A be an infinite subset of x. Capital A be an infinite subset of x. As this A is sequentially compact, so every sequence in this matrix space has convergent subsequence. So since x is sequentially compact, therefore for any sequence suppose sequence is xn has a convergent subsequence, suppose sequence is xnk, has subsequence xnk which converges to some point in that x, which converges to a point, suppose x small x in the matrix space x. So our this is the given thing that x is sequentially compact, so every sequence in that matrix space has convergent subsequence. So here we have assumed that this is sequentially compact and A is infinite subset of x. So our claim is, now we will prove that this point for which x n k converges, this point is limit point of given infinite subset. Now we will prove that this x is limit point of A. So our claim is, x is limit point of A means we know that limit point from the FYBSC, we have seen that the definition of limit point. We say that given element is limit point because there are some elements which are very close to that point. X is limit point of A means there are maximum number of elements of A which are very close to this x, then we say that x is limit point of A. So here our claim is x is limit point of A. Now here we have sequence xnk, that is subsequence of xn, that is xnk is converges to x in x, as the sequence xnk converges to x in x. Therefore we can use the definition of convergence for given epsilon positive, there exists some n belongs to set of natural numbers, capital N belongs to set of natural numbers such that distance between this x and xnk less than epsilon, distance between x and xnk is less than epsilon for all n greater equal n. Distance between x and xnk less than epsilon for all n greater equal n. So this implies, so we can use the definition of open sphere. So this implies that xnk is distance between x and xnk is less than epsilon, means this xnk lies inside the open sphere centered at this x and radius epsilon. This implies xnk belongs to the open sphere centered at x and radius epsilon for all n greater equal n by definition of open sphere. So Yes, we have this open sphere X n k contains an elements of this E n k. This open sphere S epsilon of X contains elements of X n k for all n greater equal n. So these all are elements of A, because A is an infinite subset of A. Thus S epsilon of X contains an elements of X n k, elements of X n k for some n greater equal n. These elements are of A, because A is an infinite subset of that metric space. So this infinite set, from that those infinite elements, there are some elements which are in X n k. So this S epsilon of X contains elements of X n k for n greater equal n of A. These are some elements of X n k are some elements of A. So this open sphere contains elements of A. That is, this implies that this open sphere contains some elements of A, means there are elements of A which are very close to X, because some elements of X n k which are the elements of A lies inside the open sphere S epsilon of X. Epsilon is very small number. So for that open sphere, there are some elements of X n k for all in greater equal n are very close to X. So this implies X is limit point of A. This implies X is limit point of A. X is limit point of A. This A was arbitrary infinite set and for which X is limit point. This implies that every infinite subset of matrix space X D has limit. Thus every infinite subset of X, has a limit point, in X. Hence, this is the definition of BWP, that this means that X has BWP. This is the proof of first part. Now, conversely, we will suppose X has BWP, and our claim is to prove that X is sequentially compact. Now, conversely, assume that X has BWP. X has Bolzano's Weierstrass property. That is, BWP means every infinite subset of X has limit point. That is, every infinite subset of X has limit point in X. Now our claim is to prove that given matrix space XD is sequentially compact. That is, we have to prove that every sequence in that matrix space has convergent subsequence, for which let Xn be an arbitrary sequence in X, Our claim is this Xn has convergent subsequence. The sequence Xn has convergent subsequence. Now, here there are two possibilities. We have assumed that X has BWP, means every infinite subset has limit point. If A is finite, then we have to prove that Xn has convergent subsequence. And now, if A is infinite, then also we have to prove that this Xn has convergent subsequence. So we will take two cases. Case first, if A is finite, this case occurs because we have supposed that every infinite subset of x has limit point. So we can write infinite subset as suppose x comma x comma x comma x single x infinitely many times, then that set is also infinite, but there is only one distinct element, so that set will be the finite. Or we can take x1, x2 up to xn, again x1, x2 up to xn, these n elements infinitely many times, then that set will becomes infinite, but there are actually n distinct elements. So this case occurs of if A is finite set, if A is finite set. So this case is possible, this is possible only when at least one element of this set, at least one element, maybe 2, 3, 4 elements, but at least one element in A appears infinitely many times, appears infinitely many times in A. We say that we have every infinite subset has limit point, but if we take here, we are taking the case that A is finite set. So if we write this A is equals to x1, x2, x3, x4, then x5 comma x5 comma x5 comma x5 infinitely many times, then we can see that that set is infinite, but there are only 5 distinct element x1, x2 up to x5, and x5 is repeated infinitely many times. So this is the this case is possible only when at least one element, there may be one more than one element. If you take suppose x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, x4, x5, x4, x5 infinitely many times, then there are 2 elements which are repeated. So this case is possible only when at least one element in A appears infinitely many times in A. Infinitely many times in A. So for that sequence, if you take the sequence, then that element which is repeated infinitely many times appears again in that sequence. So in this sequence, you can write directly this at least one element in A appears infinitely many times in this sequence xn. Xn is arbitrary sequence in that x. So this element that appears infinitely many times also in xn. So we can say that there are x, suppose x5 is element which appears infinitely many times, and that is that element is also in xn. So this xn converges to that particular element. Then we get a constant sequence. Then we get a constant subsequence. A constant subsequence, and hence that is, if we take the subsequence of that sequence such that the only element that appears infinitely many times that repeats itself, so that will be the constant sequence. Hence that sequence, constant sequence, is convergent. Hence we get a convergent subsequence. Hence we get a convergent subsequence. So in the first case we have a convergent subsequence, so our claim is completed in this first case. Now the case second is A if A is an infinite set, A is an infinite set. Now since x has BWP, we have assumed that x has BWP. Since x has Bolzano's Weierstrass property and A is an infinite set, and A is an infinite set, therefore by definition of BWP, this A has a limit point. Therefore, A has limit point. A has a limit point. Suppose that limit point will be x in x. A has limit point x in x. Then we have to prove that our claim is Xn has convergent subsequence. Now, if you take this sequence in this A, then that sequence must have a convergent subsequence. Now, we will find some elements of the subsequence, that is, we will find the subsequence which is convergent. So, then S1 of x, this x is limit point of A, that is, there are infinitely many points which are very close to x. So, if you take 1 as radius and this x as a center, then this S1 of x must have, this S1 of x must have an infinitely many points of A, because this x is limit point of A. So, there are infinitely many points of A which are very close to x. So, if we take 1 as a radius, then we have this S1 of x must have an infinitely many elements of A, that is infinitely many elements of A. S1 of x must have an infinitely elements of A, because x is limit point. So, there are lot of points of A which are very close to x. So, if you take 1 as a radius and x as a center and draw the open sphere, then that open sphere contains infinitely many points of A other than singleton x. So, x1 of x must have an infinitely many elements of A. Now, again if we consider the open sphere, so this S1 of x has infinitely many points of A. So, we choose one element, let us choose one such element means which is very close to x, one such element, suppose that element will be xn1 other than that singleton x, other than that center, other than x. Again, we will draw the another open sphere, again S1/2 of x. This open sphere also have infinitely many elements. This open sphere S1/2 of x must have an infinitely many infinitely many elements of A. Again, we will choose, suppose xn2. So, choose xn2 for n2 is greater than n1. So, xn1, n2. So, this another xn2 which is very close to x, not exactly x. Similarly, S1/3 of x contains infinitely many elements, because x is limit point of A. So, this open sphere also contains infinitely many elements of A other than x. Hence, we choose xn3 for n3 greater than n2, and so on. That is, if we repeat this procedure, we will get the sequence xn1, xn2, xn3 up to so on. In this way, we get we get a subsequence, suppose xnk of this given sequence xn, such that these xnk's belongs to the open sphere S1/k times x. For xn3 we have this open sphere, for xn2 we have this open sphere. So, for xnk we have the open sphere S1/k times x for all k, that is k running from 1 to so on. This implies that distance between this xnk and x is less than 1/k. This implies distance between xnk and this x is less than 1 by k, is less than 1 by k, and this distance tends to 0 as k tends to infinity, because for k is the natural number, as k tends to infinity 1 upon k tends to 0. So, this distance tends to 0 as k tends to infinity. This implies that distance of x n k x tends to 0 as k tends to infinity means this x n k tends to x, that is x n k converges to x. Hence, every sequence x n has convergent subsequence. Hence, every sequence x n has a convergent subsequence, has a convergent subsequence. This implies x is sequentially compact, x is sequentially compact. Hence, the proof of given theorem, that is the x is sequentially compact if and only if it has BWP, hence the proof.